be profitable turn around. There is somebody here. That which has not been working well in your life will start working very well. The things that have brought you pain will start bringing you pleasure. The things that have made you to bow your head and shake your head in sorrow will start bringing you joy. That was called a profitable turnaround. In the book of Philemon, chapter 1, that's the new chapter there, 10 and 11. People will be looking for their Bible where Philemon is, but you will look for it today. Book of Philemon, chapter 1, only one chapter. 10 to 11. Thank God for, you see now? You see where that is? You see what I'm talking about? Because it's not a popular part. Not Philippians. Philemon. Glory be to God. I beseech thee for my son Onesimus, whom I have begotten in my bonds, which in time past was to thee unprofitable, but now profitable to thee and to me. Let me read it again. 10. I beseech thee for my son Onesimus, whom I have begotten in my bonds. 11. Which in time past was to be unprofitable, but now profitable to thee and to me. I'm praying that which was not profitable for you before will start becoming very profitable. The profitable turnaround. You know, the book of Philemon is not a popular portion of the scripture. Preachers, including me, preach day to day, week to week, month to month, sometimes year to year. So preachers, I tell you, I've never stopped by this particular book to minister. I'm telling you, it's just one chapter with 25 verses. I don't know, Philemon must be lonely. A lonely book that nobody stopped by. But there is no portion of the scripture that truth is not embedded. Or you cannot extract something that God will use to minister to you. What is the background story of this book, Philemon? Apostle Paul wrote this book when he was in prison. He was an elderly man at that time, not the young man going up and down, but he was in prison. And he wrote it to Philemon. Philemon happened to be a well-to-do believer. When he was outside, he must have ministered to him, got him converted. So Philemon happened to be one of his sons in the Lord. And he now started working as a co-laborer. But Philemon had a slave called Onesimus. That slave must have done something wrong, or must have taken or stolen the valuable of his master, Philemon, and he ran away. Most of those days, slaves were properties. So for them to run away, it's like you bought them and you are at a loss. And when they catch such slaves, they normally cut their hair or do something to mar their physical outlook. But he ran away. But something happened. Maybe he now came to the prison, or he did something and he was arrested. And because of that, Apostle Paul met with this Onesimus and minister Christ to him. He got converted and he now became profitable to him. He was assisting him even in the prison, meaning that his conversion was not genuine. He was not interested in doing any bad thing or defrauding anyone as maybe he did his master. And his master must have been feeling bitter that when I will see this guy again, I don't know what I would do for him. Even as a believer, sometimes it happens when some people hurt us. And by the time Onesimus was about to leave the prison, he now took time to write this letter of Philemon to David's son. When you read it, or maybe on your own, you read just 25 verses. And he praised him, and he trusted him that what appeal he was about to give to him, he will agree. And that's when he now started writing that Onesimus, though he was unprofitable to you before, but now, trust me, it will be very, very profitable. And he used to be your slave. I don't want you to treat him as a slave, treat him as a brother, because he is now my son in the Lord. I begot him when I was in my bone, in the prison, just as I begot you. If there's anything that he has done that you want him to pay it back, just charge it to me. I will pay. When you read it, you will see. But what we are just trying to bring out is somebody that was not profitable before. God can touch the person and now become extremely profitable. And that is your own story.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
When our mommy was ministering, she opened to one of the parts of the scripture that I'm planning to use today, Luke chapter 5. But I'm going to be starting from 5, not 4 that she started, from 5 to 7. When Peter, he had toiled all night, that net was not profitable to him. But when Jesus Christ came, this equation changed. He could not catch a single fish all through the night, but in just a few moments, he was not even able to draw the net again. What happened to the net? The same net. But something has changed. I'm prophesying into your life. You could be the same person that has not been bringing profit, but I prophesy into your life that you start bringing great profit.
Yeah.
The same person that people are seeing as not valuable, but after now, people will see you as of great worth.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. And Simon answering said unto him, Master, we have toiled all the night and have taken nothing. Nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down the net. And when they had this done, they enclosed a great multitude of fishes, and their nets break. And they beckoned unto their partners, which were in the other ship, that they should come and help them. And they came and filled both the ships, so that they began to sink. What happened to the net? It was not the same net. They didn't go and import another net, but that same one. Just like Onesimus, he told him that he was not profitable to you, but please take him back. You'll be amazed at the way he will serve you, at the way he will be praying for you. The profit he will be bringing to you will be more than what you have even lost to him. I'm prophesying into your life. Anything that has not worked well, I'm saying it again, will start working well in your life.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
When I look at my life, I can be an example of that. Funny as it may seem to some people, I used to be regarded as the black sheep of my family. Black sheep of my family in the sense that anything, I was just off the other people in the family. You know, whenever something, even as little as I was, whenever something was spoiled in the family, in our house those days, get the first suspect. It's yours really, it's me. Most of the time, they were true. they were right. But sometimes you are not right. And sometimes the person that will spoil it will be hiding under that something that is mean that they will always call. And the person will now not talk. And that time he used to pay me. He used to pay me much because I know that I'm not the one that did this one. It got so bad to an instant, to a particular time, that my mom kept something in the fridge. I can't remember what it was, sir. But the thing got missing. I went to open the fridge that particular day. So one morning, I can remember, I was 6'4". Who took something here? Nobody said anything. I was thinking that somebody that took it would say. There will not be many only me that have not been asked. Tokubo, come. Who took something here? I said it was me. I was not the one. Because I said that it had got that bad. I said it was me. You this boy? I don't understand you. I will report to your father. And he should not call my father. He said that, you know what this boy just did? He went to take this. I don't know when he did he even take it overnight or something. My father now said, what was the thing? And she mentioned it. I can't even remember the thing. I was the one that took it now. And they were looking at me. They did not just understand me. I said, why did you lie? That you are the one that you on yourself. That is because you will not believe me. Because everybody has already said they were not the one. Well, of course, my dad was not there. I said that, who will it be now? He said that it's me that is always doing bad thing. So, it's me. It was that bad. I can't remember any of my siblings that had to repeat any class. Because I had to change school. They had to, because of the way I was going down academically, they had to change my school to another place. And they said that, no, you can't start from here, go down 2 steps. I can't remember any one of them. They had to do, I had to go to some of the things that I went to. I can't remember any one of them that my dad had to tell that we are a disappointment. But I thank God that maybe of late, things have changed.
Yes.
In the sense that even the commendation that I'm getting from the same man is, I cannot even tell any of my siblings some of the things that he sees. But it's just to tell you that God is the same one yesterday, today, and forever. He said that this guy, he was unprofitable before, but now, as he has met with Christ, he has now become extremely profitable to thee and to me. I'm prophesying into your life. In whatever area of your life that things have not worked, let them start working extremely well. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Also, Peter, there was a particular time he denied Jesus Christ with an oath in the book of Matthew chapter 26, 73 and 74. Matthew 26, 73 and 74. They asked him 3 times. This guy looks like one of the disciples. He was even swearing. But this same guy is pseudo. After a while, that was not profitable to his master. You mean he has invested all these 3.5 years and you will just come and you will say you don't, he will say he did not know him. Not that, please, so I'm not for some of the things that he was saying. He said, I never knew him. And after a while, came unto him they that stood by and said to Peter, surely thou also art one of them. For thy speech beware thee. Then began he to curse and to swear, saying, I know not the man. And immediately the cock crew. But after a while, this unprofitable disciple to Jesus Christ became extremely profitable. He did not deny him anymore. In fact, he was telling about him, and so many people were now coming to Jesus Christ through him. In the book of Acts chapter 2 verse 14, Acts chapter 2 verse 14, he stood higher than other disciples. I did not mind. The Bible said that there were multitudes. When they say multitude, I know that if it were to be 5,000, they would have said that multitude, he did not even care this time around. The time that he was denying him, they didn't even say that there were multitude there. And Peter, standing up with the 11, lifted up his voice and said unto them, ye men of Judea, and all ye that dwell in Jerusalem, be this known unto you, and hearken to my words. Can you go to 41? Go to 41. Let's see the result of his ministration that day. 41. Acts 2, 41. Acts 2, 41. 3,000 people were converted. Something did not have 41. Then, they that gladly received his word were baptized. And the same day, there were added unto them about how many?
3,000
souls. In Acts 4:4. There was another time he had to minister with John again. This time around, not 3,000, but 5,000. Howbeit, many of them, we heard the word, believed, and the number of the men was about 5,000. I prophesy into your life. Has somebody betrayed you? Has somebody denied you? Have you gone into any venture that is something did not, you put all your resources, it did not work, but things have changed today. In your life, you will start receiving, profiting from where you did not receive profit. I remember about 2 years ago, my dear son is not, he's sleeping right now. So during the family phone day, when we finished, some people were giving away medals. He did not, maybe he just thought that, how could pastor be giving other people? Most of me, he was angry. I don't even know anything that he was angry. He just came to my house. I did not even know where my car was parked. He just put paint, carpet. This is no way he got back up paint. The color of my car happened to be this metallic gold. Just put blue, just flashed it in anger. And nobody knew, I just came and I just who did all this thing? Then somebody said, I saw somebody that was always sometimes will come here and be making noise like that. I just knew that it was him. When some brothers in the church got to hear about it, they said that, Pastor, just give us the permission to deal with him on your behalf. I said, no worry. When a father has, there are different children that the father has. The father, the child is not, it does not mean that you will now say the child is not your child. Even though some people say that, but they are just saying their own. I said, don't worry. I'll think of what to do for him. Come on, what happened? Okay, say that, let's banish him from this church. Just give us the permission, we know what to do. I said, don't worry. So, it cost me quite something. I called somebody, they painted the place, and then he disappeared from here. He knew what he had done, or maybe the thing that came to him. What did he do? I didn't see him for a while. Then by the time I would see him, nobody was even around that day. I just saw somebody open the door, and the next thing, just frustrated, and just was on the knee, on the floor. I just sat. I said, what would I do now? I just told him, I don't mean get something, you can get up. And I said, I just did warning to him, and I said, that he did not know, brother. So, but after that time, he had been profitable to me. He had blessed me with gifts. He will use his money to buy gifts for me. He will wash my car. Sometimes he will even be doing SSS for me. He will be doing protection. He sits me outside. There was one time he told me around 5:02 that I think I was trying to go. He was stopping car for me. I mean, you were not profitable before, but you are not become profitable. I'll prophesy into your life. Anything that has not pleased you before now, by the reason of this message and the word of God, can never come back to you. But there is a reason why this is coming your way today. Today is the turning point. Any business, you have put your hand in different businesses, it has not worked. But from now on, anyone that your hand will be put on, just like Peter, they will start working. Work more than you have ever imagined. Press your feet and pray and say, Father, the anointing for profitability. In the name of Jesus. Anointing for profitability. Let it rest upon my life. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. The same Peter that was, I received a call yesterday. You know, by God's grace, God gave me the opportunity to minister at our provincial headquarters, Big Free House, yesterday at the grand finale of the year. So somebody now called me, one auntie, one elderly person. Yesterday, it's a long time the person called me. It was another phone. He said that, this is Mama, so. I said, where's Mama? He said that, I was told that you plan to preach at Big Free House. I said that, your brother or sister, I think one of those people that we grew up together, was there. I said that you won't believe what your son, he don't show you, she was telling her that, what your son had now become. I said, I have his number, let me still call him. And she called me. I was now looking back, say, wow, how things can change by God. I'm praying for you that from today, that turning point has come into your life. Yeah. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. And before the end of this week, there will be great prophecy in all your life. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Let me know.